I think, yeah, it can be a force for good or a force for infinite mischief. You know, and that therefore depends entirely on the laws, the regulations, the way with all of how we use these systems, and the policy and the politicians that underpin it. The problem is that you know, market forces will drive an outcome. So if you look at relators, you look at environmental issues, you look at environmental crisis, you know, tsunamis, you look at wildlife, you know, there's a whole range of spaces that drones are a fantastic solution to understanding, guessing what's on the other side of the hill. They're not going to go away anytime soon, and no amount of what I call well-intentioned sort of what I call control and policies are going to sort of work necessarily stop that. And so therefore they're going to be with us. From a military perspective, they're in fact an extraordinarily useful tool. The vast majority of drones look. They don't, you know, everybody sees Reapers and Predator as in fact being sort of, you know, the armed response to a problem. You're not going to undo the technology. They're a tool. They're a means. The question which I think is being raised and will be answered, or at least addressed and discussed and dialogued tonight, is the attraction they presented to policymakers and politicians as an ends rather than a means. To me as a practitioner, they are an indispensable tool in the pursuit of military objectives. You know, unmanned drones are not unmanned. If you want to see, you know, you see a Predator flying, you know, there's about 140 people behind that single weapon system or that single surveillance system, reconnaissance system up in the sky. What you haven't got is a pilot in the damn thing, but it's bloody well manned. And you've got a whole range of people, lawyers and a whole range of other people who in fact are looking at the same picture technology, the same circumstances, the same context in which you now, in fact, are asking, if you are to use it on an armed mission, of it being able to use that weapon system. So it's not devoid of morality or ethical or legal boundaries. It pushes up towards them, but it does present that. In many ways, actually, the precision with which you can apply these things is so much more accurate than, you know, for instance, you know, take when we went into Afghanistan in 2001, you know, a B-52, dumb bomb, carpet bombing, is just that. You know, it kills anything and everything in that swathe that it hits. You go back to the Second World War, to Korea, you look at artillery strikes and the like. You know, these are very, very indiscriminate.